guys, Matthias Allred here. Welcome to Utah Real Estate Buzz. Check out today's weekly sales tip. Okay, so here's a typical real estate curve. You see the downward trends and the upward trends. And what I'm hearing from a lot of people right now is that they want to buy at the bottom of the cycle. They don't want to buy and then see their house prices decrease anymore. And so for the last couple of years, we've seen this downward trend. Housing prices have gone down in value. And some people are sitting on the fence saying, I don't want to buy right now. I want to wait until the market rebounds and starts to come back up before they buy. Again, their fear is they don't want to buy up here and see their house prices start to decline. So what I want to show you guys right now is a few great sales tips as to why it's good to buy right here as opposed to waiting and buying on the upswing right now. Okay, a few things that play a big factor into this are the seller's motivation. Okay, when sellers are motivated to move their house, you often get more closing costs, you get lower price on your home, and you actually get better incentives for buying the home. And what I mean by that is that the sellers are willing to give up more on the property because they're concerned that they might not be able to sell the home. Okay, extra incentives may be, again, better closing costs. They might mean that they'll replace the carpet or give a carpet allowance, that they'll leave certain furniture, those type of things right there. Okay, on the downward trend, there tend to be more homes on the market, which means you have a longer negotiation time, which again means that you get a better deal on the home because, again, sellers are concerned that their house might not sell. They have this big fear that's driving them, meaning we've got to get rid of it. Housing prices are going down. Let's sell, 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 sell. Okay, on the opposite side, if you end up buying over here after the market's rebounded on its way back up, sellers become a lot less motivated. Offers come in a little bit faster. The sellers tend to give up less on the property. There's less homes on the market, which means offers come in faster. You get multiple offers. And that fear we were talking about turns into greed. So on the downward side, where you make an offer here, you're actually buying a home below that price because you're getting the extra incentives and everything. If you wait until the market's rebounded on its way back up, you actually buy at a higher price than you would because of the greed, because of the multiple offers and the actually getting less. So, okay, hopefully that gives you a few ideas on how to talk to your buyers that are sitting on the fence right now. Give them that little extra nudge to buy now as opposed to waiting for later. If you're watching this for the first time, appreciate you tuning in. Go ahead and subscribe for free. Make sure you get all the videos that we send out. Go ahead and forward this to all your friends and coworkers in the office, and make sure you go ahead and post this on Facebook for us. Stay tuned. We'll talk to you next time.